next. Some drink? Do you want some drink?
Okay.
Mariana, do you want a drink? Apple juice or water? Go, Benji.
I'm honored to stand here this evening, on this field, at this school, before the friends and family of the class of 2013. Welcome. Many predicted that I would never make it to this night.
Yeah, it's true.
To our graduation, many did not even believe I would make it to high school. Well, here I am. Here we are. Congratulations, class of 2013. I want you to take a minute to think about where you have been, where you are now in your life, and where you're going. When I was 14, I had a dream. Growing up in a family that did not have much money, I learned early on that the odds were stacked against me. In the summer after eighth grade, I went to my aunt and uncle's house. I went there because they were helping me complete my summer reading assignment. I thought I was staying for the weekend. After 4 years, it has become my home. In that house, I learned a lesson that we must all learn. The only difference between success and failure is massive action. We cannot get to where we are going on our own. I recall one conversation that I had with my uncle when he had asked me, what kind of life do you want? What sort of person do you want to be? What are you willing to do to succeed? My uncle said, most people dream, but they do not act. They dream, but they do not decide. They let their fears hold them back, because once you decide, if you really commit to it, there is no coming back. Only when you choose the life you want will your world change. So, I would ask you, my fellow classmates, whether you just want to dream about your future or whether you're ready to take massive action to achieve your dreams. It was choosing to act that got me here tonight. It was choosing to act that led me into enrolling into college for the fall. But it was also choosing to listen to my aunt and to my uncle, who I love the most, to my coaches and to my teachers, that helped me realize the dream that is coming true tonight. People often ask me, how did you keep going when times were tough? I always offered short answers, determination, strong will and vision, I may say. I hesitate to tell the real story because it is simply beyond the reality of most people. So I just say very little. From the time I arrived at Burlingame High School, as a freshman, my future was clear. My education now continues from high school and into college, where I want to learn not how to climb the corporate ladder, but how to build and own the ladder I climb. I was determined to create a new reality, my own reality. I told you about my past and my present, but what about our future? The one we must all create for ourselves when we leave here tonight. The next phase of my journey is not just about football, as so many believe. Is not just about football, as so many believe, or living out someone else's dreams for me. It was about finding a different world, a better world, because it was a search for that world that kept me going these last 4 years. As we begin this next stage of the journey, we must do all we can to be brave, stay humble, study hard, and keep learning. Because the journey is in our hearts and in our minds. It has very little to do with the world outside of us and everything to do with the reality we create inside of us. I would like to leave you, my fellow classmates, with the gift of 3 lessons that have kept me going these past 4 years. First, define your goals. A goal without an agenda is just a dream. Second, embrace all challenges. If it does not challenge you, it will not change you. And last, the greatest gift that anyone can give to another, a gift that my grandpa and grandma had given to me, faith. They believed in me, and I believe in the class of 2013. I challenge you tonight, as my aunt and uncle challenged me 4 years ago, to begin your journey. Don't just dream, take massive action. Because massive action demands that we do everything we must to achieve our dreams. To master our craft in anything and everything we do. As Robert Frost wrote, two roads diverge in a wood. And I took the one less traveled by. And that has made all the difference. And that has made all the difference. Thank you. Beast mode.